Mr. Madhav Lal, Secretary MSME, Professor Alag, dignitaries on the dais, ladies and gentlemen. I am indeed thankful to the Foundation for MSME Clusters for organizing this international conference and giving me an opportunity to speak on the subject of sustainable financing of SMEs, which is really very dear to my heart. I would use the term SMEs and MSMEs interchangeably because that is how the sector is defined today as MSME actually. Before I touch upon the crux of the topic, I'll briefly touch upon the importance of clusters also. I believe that clusters provide a stabilizing force and act as an engine for growth of the economy. In fact, the significance of clusters was noted as far back as 1890 by the famous classical economist Alfred Marshall, who referred to clusters as the industrial districts having concentration of specialized industries in particular localities. These industrial districts gave rise to external economies that particularly favored small enterprises through creating opportunities for easy access to a pool of skilled labor, subsidiary trades, and communication network. And of course, no word on clusters is complete without a reference to the seminal work of Michael Porter on his analysis of clusters. His analysis of clusters looks at clusters where the competitiveness of one company is related to the performance of other companies and other factors tied in the value-added chain in customer-client relation or in a local or regional context. The Porter analysis classifies phenomena of industrial development leading to the competitive advantage of nations. And lastly, let me also quote the famous Professor Jocelyn Gent Mallet of Illinois University, who had said that clusters are attractive for various reasons. They catalyze economic transformation, they drive growth and enhance stability. Once they are rooted, they are remarkably self-generating. Clusters look like a good bet for economic success. No wonder everyone wants them. I think the key word here in this quote was economic success, which, as far as we in SIDBI are concerned, depends largely on access to credit by MSMEs. We at SIDBI have realized this since our inception in 1990 and have also understood the importance of sustainability in the process. Thus, SIDBI emphasizes on sustainable MSME finance. We all know that adequate, timely, and affordable credit is a sine qua non for faster growth of the MSME sector. In India, as per the fourth MSME census 2006-07, only about 5% of the MSMEs are able to meet their credit requirements from formal institutions like banks. This sector, comprising more than 45 million units, primarily relies on informal sources like personal savings, borrowings from friends and relatives, money lenders, and trade credit. This shows that there is a vast segment of the MSME sector, mostly micro enterprises, which are financially excluded. There is therefore a necessity to have a focused financial inclusion plan for small enterprises through enabling policies and measures. And one of the major measures, policy measures taken by the Reserve Bank of India is that credit to the MSE sector is treated as priority sector lending. Further, banks have been advised to achieve a 20% year-on-year growth in the credit to MSEs, a 10% annual growth in the number of micro enterprise accounts, and 60% of total lending to the MSE sector is to be marked for micro enterprises. In addition, loans up to 10 lakh rupees are to be given without collateral securities. Due to these measures, I would like to mention that the credit by scheduled commercial banks to MSEs increased appreciably by about 30% in financial year 2013, and again in the current year up to December by about 24% has been the increase. While this is to some extent comforting, there still remains a big gap between the demand and supply. And according to the Planning Commission, the credit gap for MSE sector was estimated at 62% at the beginning of the 12th five-year plan, and this was also corroborated by an international study by IFC IntelliCap in 2012, which estimated the gap at around 70%, and more particularly the gap in equity in the MSME sector at around 95%. Therefore, we have to come out with innovative mechanisms and channels to enhance the access of credit to MSMEs. And obviously, one such innovative financing model is cluster-based financing, which is a promising and internationally validated model of meeting the credit needs of the MSMEs. The cluster-based model offers banks a number of benefits, like dealing with well-defined and recognized groups, availability of appropriate information for risk assessment, easy monitoring by the lending institutions, and more importantly, lower transaction costs through reduction in costs of data standardization and reduction of documentation. As I mentioned earlier, SIDBI, right from inception, has adopted a cluster approach towards lending, and our 90-odd branches today in the country are all located in major industrial clusters in the country. I will illustrate with a few examples as to how we have gone about in cluster-based lending. Sometime back, we entered into an arrangement with an industry association in a major cluster near Delhi. And this is a unique experiment made by any bank or financial institution so far. Under the arrangement, while SIDBI makes the loan, the association takes upon itself the responsibility of identifying responsible borrowers from amongst its members and does a part of the initial due diligence and also agrees to do the necessary follow-up for repayment. And we pay them a small percentage out of our interest earnings also. Now, this kind of a pilot initiative has turned out to be a major success and has been recognized by the government and Reserve Bank of India also. And about 100-odd cases done by us under this initiative, not a single case has turned into an NPA. Secondly, infrastructure requires development and modernization in many clusters. Many a times, finance is not readily available for development of such infrastructure. We in SIDBI have made an inroad into financing such activities. For example, we have financed cluster-based projects, including a water supply project at the hosiery cluster at Tirupur, a convention center at Bangalore, an exhibition center which is only second to the Pragati Maidan at Coimbatore, and common effluent treatment plants at a large number of clusters, besides coming out with customized credit facilities for various clusters. Third, we have created a system of accredited consultants which would handhold the MSE sector in terms of preparing their project reports, because this is the biggest pain area when a promoter approaches a bank. Today, we have 280 enlisted accredited consultants with us who help MSMEs in preparing bankable project reports. And these reports through SIDBI are sent to a rating agency for being rated. So the credibility of such a project report is tremendously enhanced in the eyes of the banker, because it comes through a channel which is approved by SIDBI and is rated by an accredited rating agency. And the model has picked up, and we are getting a large number of cases now covered through this mechanism. I think coming to particularly sustainable development of MSMEs, we have taken several initiatives to promote lending for green and energy-efficient technologies in the MSME sector under the umbrella of sustainable development initiatives, including financing of energy efficiency, cleaner production, renewable energy, solar projects, mini-hydro projects, CNG commercial vehicle financing. For example, 1,000 taxis, when the court order came in Mumbai, 1,000 taxis which switched over from diesel to CNG were financed by SIDBI, amongst others. And I must emphasize that all these interventions are on cluster basis as far as possible. and are supported through a large number of lines of credit from multilateral agencies like World Bank, KfW, JICA, etc. I think no mention about sustainable financing of MSMEs would be complete without a reference to risk capital, since I earlier mentioned that the equity gap in the MSME sector is to the extent of 95%. Where do units which are on the growth curve access capital or equity to leverage further loans? There is hardly any mechanism in the country. Recognizing this need, SIDBI has a separate vertical for risk capital and a separate subsidiary for venture capital. The idea is that growing units could be given a subordinated kind of debt which is in the nature of quasi-equity, and they could access further loans against this capital from banks, that is leverage the risk capital given by SIDBI and continue their sustainable growth. I would also like to take this opportunity to share with you some of the interesting facts as far as sustainable financing is concerned in clusters. When we enter these clusters, we realize that MSMEs, they were not aware of how to improve energy efficiency or of various other areas. We undertook a series of awareness camps. Still, they did not come forth to adopt the energy efficiency measures or cleaner production technologies, notwithstanding even court orders in certain cases. But finally, when we set up a demonstration project in a particular unit and showed the amount of money being saved by that unit, and they realized that the payback period of many such measures and investments is barely between 6 months to 24 months, large number of units have come forth and adopted such measures, and some of them even did not need to resort to borrowings from banks. I think what I'm trying to drive at is what Professor Alag had mentioned about the initial hand-holding support. Basically, this is really a must if we go into cluster financing. So Professor Alag had also mentioned about a better concept of collaterals. Now, this is something we have recognized in SIDBI. One, of course, SIDBI and the Ministry of MSME have set up the Credit Guarantee Trust for Micro and Small Enterprises, which mandates that all lending which is covered under the credit guarantee scheme has to be without collateral and without a third-party guarantee. And the success of the scheme is vindicated by the fact that about 13.5 lakh units have been covered by commercial banks under this mechanism for total credit aggregating over 67,000 crore rupees as on date. Another way of looking at collateral is again what Professor Alag had referred to, you know, working with the large industry in a way. For example, the franchising industry today finds it very difficult to access finance because most of the franchisees come up in rented premises and obviously are not in a position to offer any kind of hard collateral. The way to look at financing such units is obviously to look at who is the franchisor, basically. What is the kind of due diligence done by the franchisor? And as a banker, if I am satisfied with that due diligence, I think my collateral really lies in the strength of the franchisor, who does, I personally believe, far better, who do not have, majority do not have access to bank credit. So now we are in the process of working out a mechanism with them by virtue of which this software, the IPR, could be valued and would eventually become a collateral. So this would address the issue you had raised about looking at collateral or a better concept of collateral, basically. I think, given the paucity of time, I would like to just mention that a lot of hand-holding support in terms of providing business development services in about 30-odd clusters in the country, about 800 business development services have been set up under a program with DFID UK, GIZ Germany, and the World Bank by SIDBI. We have trained more than 3,000 bankers on the concept of energy efficiency, cleaner production technologies, and environmental and social standards. And we are taking up a study in 30 clusters currently for mapping the credit gap, the gap in the business development services, infrastructure, and the marketing gap. And today we would be releasing a study on branding of clusters also. To sum up and conclude, Business clustering in MSME sector has been viewed as a channel for growth and prosperity in the sector. In a cluster-based financing model, as I have emphasized and as Professor Alagh had mentioned, it is important to note that credit delivery requires a lot of hand-holding support. And this requires demonstration of success stories and capacity building to the MSMEs. In other words, credit plus approach is required for any cluster development, and we would need to have a differentiated strategy for each cluster. We in SIDBI would continue to act as a catalyst to fuel the process of clustering in the MSME sector so that the outside world, while individual MSMEs look like one petal of a single grown-up rose, but within the cohesiveness, these petals will keep competing with each other to grow as the largest petal within that rose. Thank you for your patience.